Hi, my name is Svend Jepsen. I am a product expert on small expansion valves here in Danfoss headquarters in Norwalk. And today we are going to talk about the thermostatic expansion valve and see where it's placed and what it do. What we have here in order to show this is a typical air conditioning unit from a domestic house. We have two components. One is the outdoor unit with a compressor, and the second one is the actual cooling unit. So this is placed outdoor, and through this connection here, the two units are connected. And then here we have a fan, and the cold air is blown into your house. So now we have zoomed in on the evaporator, and this is the part where the cold air is made. And now we can see where the expansion valve is placed. And the expansion valve is this valve here, which is placed in front of the evaporator. And the expansion valve decides how much refrigerant is needed inside the evaporator based on the need for cooling, and also based on the need on the level of temperatures that are around the unit. So we have, on a normal expansion valve, we have three connectors. We have one here, that is the refrigerant coming from the outdoor unit. We have another, so that is the inlet. We have another connector here, that is the valve outlet. And this goes into some smaller tubes that are connected to the evaporator. And through here, the refrigerant will be passed to all these leads, and then they will come out up here and go back to the compressor over here. The third connector we have is this, which is called an external equalization connector, and this is part of the regulation of how the valve is working. So now we are even closer to the valve, so we can better see the valve itself. As mentioned before, we have three connections on the valve. We have a bracing connection on the inlet, which is where the refrigerant comes from the outdoor unit. We have a capillary tube here, which has to be braced into the unit, but not here. This part will come with the valve from the factory. So we will show you later on in another close-up where that is put. Then we have the outlet. This is a separate component that you buy, a distributor. You braced in your smaller copper tubes that will connect to the evaporator inlet, and then this is screwed on the valve. Then as the last part, we have this capillary tube, stainless steel, and that goes up here to the bulb. Again, in the second close-up, we will show you where the bulb is placed. This capillary tube is very sturdy, and you can just let it sit like that. You don't need to fix it anything, except please don't let it rub against a copper tube. So now we move the camera up a little bit so that we can see the outlet from the evaporator. And on the outlet, there are four outlets here, and they go into a collector tube, which is going out here and again being connected to the outdoor unit. So the copper capillary tube that we had on the valve is braced into here, and the stainless steel copper capillary tube is connected to the bulb, which is placed here on the outlet. There's a suction tube, we call it. And here you can see another valve. This is the valve, it's a different valve, but we have the same capillary tube, and then we have the stainless steel bulb, and that is placed in here and insulated. Now we have zoomed in on the bulb position. It may be a little difficult to see in this picture, but the black stuff that you can see here is insulation. And it is important, especially when the bulb is placed here in the cold area, it's it's important to insulate the bulb. The bulb is normally placed on a vertical tube, but in this case the producer of this unit has decided that this is the correct positioning. So now we are back to an overall view of the unit, and just to recap a few things, we have three connections on the valve. We have a bulb that is placed up here, and the purpose of these connections is that the expansion valve is capable to see the signal or the temperature of the refrigerant that comes out of the evaporator by the bulb here. By this tube, it can see the pressure of the refrigerant that comes out here, and it will then, based on how much the load is on the evaporator, how much cooling is needed, and it read that by this signal up here, then it will decide how much refrigerant is fed into the evaporator. So the valve is not controlling the temperature, it's also not controlling the capacity of the unit, but it is simply based on the operating parameters, injecting so much liquid that we have a special signal coming out of the evaporator. And that signal prevents us from getting liquid refrigerant out of the evaporator and back to the compressor. That would damage the compressor.